Black coffee, thanks. No sugar. I'm sweet enough as it is. Hannah. H-A-N-N-A-H. It's palindrome. It reads the same backwards as forwards. It doesn't work if you mirror it though, it's not quite symmetrical, but well, I mean, you get the idea. Sorry. Hannah Smith, I live at 31 Gladstone Street. Simon Smith. He works at Ernst Brothers Glass. They do windows, all kinds of glass. Simon does the more special work, mirror making, feature windows, artistic things, really beautiful things. A mobile phone? Yeah. Well, they have one for the glaziers, but it's only for work. I can't remember the number. Oh, it's in the kitchen. I saw it plugged into its charging cradle. Simon is 6 foot, darkish blonde hair, average build. He's clean shaven. If his beard grows, it goes ginger, so he shaves it. I mean, not that there's anything wrong with ginger hair. I bought a photo. They said a spring photo. This was taken last year on holiday in Rome. It's the best one I have. No, he doesn't have any tattoos. He has a scar down here near his stomach, past his hip. Cut himself with some glass. That was before, a long time ago. He looks just like the photo. He's not got his glasses on here though. He takes them off for the camera. But he needs them to see properly, you know. He has to read a newspaper or a menu in a restaurant. Not books so much, or watching TV. He likes TV. He was wearing a shirt. It's a blue turtleneck shirt. And jeans. He has a watch. It's a really nice one. That was a gift from his boss, Eric. He had his coat, a long grey duffel coat, like Paddington Bear. He would have taken that with him. It's not in the house. So, it was Friday evening. We had an argument. He left. On Saturday, he didn't come back. I waited all day. He was supposed to go help Eric out with something on the Saturday afternoon. They had a job, but he didn't show. So Eric was ringing on the phone. I checked at the Rock, that's our local. They said they'd seen him on the Friday night, but not since. He still wasn't back this morning. It just isn't like him at all. Still not back by dinner time. It's getting dark again. So I decided to come see you. His parents haven't heard anything either. It's the Rockington Arms, the Rock. It's run by a nice couple, Peter and Susan. There's some other regulars there that Simon likes to drink with, and the barmaid they're having sometimes, Helen. Peter said Simon had been in and had a few drinks. No. I think he spoke to Helen. She said he was upset about her argument, but I'm not sure what else he said. He likes Helen. He likes blondes. He's married a couple stuff. A stupid argument. Nothing specific. No one knows how to push your buttons better than those you're close to. No. I mean, yes, we have arguments, but no, he never runs off. He always comes back. We make up. It's always that way. A long time. We got married when I was 17. Childhood sweethearts. Something like that. Are you married, detective? Suicide? No. I mean, he would never do anything like that. He is not the kind of person to do anything like that. I mean, to hurt himself? No. No. Not drugs. I mean, he drinks. But never very much. He goes to the pub and has one or two. Sometimes we go together. He drinks wine with food, but no, he doesn't have any kind of drinking problem. Yes, there's a car that we share, a Cavalier, and a van he uses for work. It's owned by Eric, but we look after it. Both of them are there now, parked in the street. I'm not sure about the keys for the van, but I can look for you when I get back. No. I'm not sure what strange would be, but he hasn't been acting odd. He's been busy at work, but nothing too stressful. Sure, yes, of course, if that would help. Will you phone the house to let me know when you want to come round? Then I can make sure that I'm there. He has a wallet, a huge, silly thing. Leather, real leather, I think. He packs it full of stuff, business cards, receipts, lottery tickets. He always carries it in his back pocket. I think that's why he's got a bad back. Offsets the discs. I haven't seen it, so he must have it on him. He always takes it out of his back pocket before, when he comes in, if he's in the house. Yes, that would be in his wallet. It's a Visa, a silver one. He doesn't like to spend money he doesn't have, so he usually pays with cash, but Eric convinced him to get one. Sure, I think. I do all the bills and paperwork and handle all the money stuff, so it should be easy for me to find. Do you want them dropped off to you? Yes, there's an Amstrad one. No one uses it for very much. There's a printer so you can write letters on it. Simon sometimes plays games, you know, climb the tower, save the princess, that kind of thing. No, he doesn't keep a diary. That's my thing. I've kept one, well, as long as I can remember, since I was a girl. Helps make sense of my day. And when you're forced to put something into words, it just gives you perspective. Everyone's on the same page. Simon isn't the type to run off or do anything crazy. Someone must have done something to him, or there must have been some kind of accident. So what do we do next? Thanks. Please find Simon. I love him so much.